Have you heard of camel milk yet? If not, you might be missing out on the latest superfood trend. With claims that it can do everything from lower blood sugar to boost the immune system, I'm taking a closer look at the science today to tell you if camel milk should be part of your diet. So stay tuned. Hey everyone, Erin here with Healthy Mom, Happy Family, and I want to talk to you today about something that's been coming onto my radar a bit more. Camel milk. Have you heard of it? Well, camel milk has been around for centuries, but it's starting to pick up steam here in the US due to a lot of science and research behind it. There's claims that camel milk can do everything from lower blood sugar in people with diabetes to even help boost our immune system and help us to fight off viruses. So I wanted to take a closer look at the research behind it so I could tell you if it's really worth drinking camel milk or not. So let's take a look. Camel milk may be better tolerated to people who have milk sensitivities. Did you know that as much as 65% of the world's population is sensitive to lactose? That's the sugar that's found in milk. Now, camel milk has less lactose than traditional cow's milk, and that's why some people with lactose intolerances can tolerate camel milk better. Now, there's also a difference in the proteins we find in camel milk and traditional cow milk in the US. Cow milk in the US contains two types of proteins, what we call A1 and A2 protein. For some people, trying to digest that A1 protein can cause gastrointestinal distress, similar to what we see in a lactose intolerance. Now, in camel milk, you only get the A2 protein, and that's why, for some people, it's much easier for them to tolerate and to digest. The nutrition profile of camel milk is also a little bit superior to cow's milk. When we look at it, camel milk is higher in vitamins like iron and vitamin C, not incredibly high, it's still not a great source of it, but it does have a little bit more than cow's milk. It's also a little bit lower in total fat and saturated fat than traditional cow's milk. However, the calories and the protein content are pretty comparable. One really surprising benefit of camel milk is what it can do for blood sugar and insulin, especially with people who have diabetes. There are components in camel milk, the proteins in it, that act like insulin in the body and lower blood sugar. Research has found that taking 2 cups of camel milk per day can significantly improve insulin sensitivity and lower blood sugar in people who have diabetes. Camel milk may also benefit our immune system. Now, having a strong immune system is something we all should strive for. And there's components in cow's milk that have antifungal, antibacterial, and antiviral properties. So research has found that consuming camel milk may help to support a healthy immune system. Another benefit to camel milk is how versatile it is. You can pretty much do everything you can do with cow's milk with camel milk. You can cook with it, you can drink it, you can even get it powdered. So there's really no limit to how you can incorporate it into your diet. So is there any downside? Well, there is one con when it comes to camel milk, the cost. You know, we just don't have as many camels in our country as we have domestic cows. And camels also produce much less milk than a cow. So there's going to be a shorter supply to meet the demand. And that's why the price point of camel milk is significantly higher than that of cow's milk. So the question you're probably all thinking is, well, what's it taste like? Well, it tastes like milk. It has a little bit of a sweet, salty taste to it. So you might take a little bit of time to get accustomed to it, but just like milk, you can incorporate it in a variety of ways. You can even flavor it. So if you want to add it to your diet, there's a lot of things you can do with camel milk. So what's the verdict when it comes to camel milk? Well, the research shows that there's definitely health benefits, especially when it comes to naturally regulating blood sugar and reducing insulin sensitivity. And it may help to support a healthy immune system. But the price point is prohibited for a large amount of people. So my recommendation, if you can afford it and you want to try it, I think it can be a great choice for a balanced diet. But if you can't, you can still balance your diet in plenty of ways to support a healthy immune system and lower blood sugar. So have you tried camel milk yet? Let me know in the comments below and tell me, what did you think? And if you liked today's video, don't forget to subscribe so you never miss a new video. Thanks for joining me.